very hot weather, very dry conditions. People are concerned about losing their plants. A lot of people get confused on how much to water, how often to water. So that's been the main question.
And not only concerned about losing plants, I know you've brought along a beautiful ornamental grass, and you've brought along a hardy sparkling juniper, which is your suggestion for those of you who lost cedars. We had a really bad year, I guess. It was described the worst in 25 years. So many people lost their ornamental cedars.
Yes, and there's a misconception with emerald cedars. Most people put them in the same category as junipers. That's not the case. Cedars actually require quite a bit more water, more frequently. So if you are experiencing problems with your cedars, having a hard time keeping them alive, the Spartan juniper is a much better choice for you. It's drought tolerant, cold tolerant, and the pine heat.
Well, I hope I was reading your minds when I asked Hamler to bring along some really, really low maintenance, easy keepers, and we'll talk about that in a moment. But a lot of what you're hearing in the greenhouse right now, Jamie, is about the pests. And shoot, we actually have pictures. We have, I believe we're starting with the cinch bug. Tell us about the cinch bug and what that little guy does.
So they damage lawn a lot. Lawn will become brown and die off. The easiest way to know if you have a cinch bug or something else is to go and look. You'll be able to see them.
You showed us a grader. We just have an image on the screen of what the damage looks like. So where do you look? Do you kind of like lift up the dead grass?
They'll be in the grass. They're pretty small, so you have to look a lot. But you'll see the damage and you'll know either the cinch bug or grass.
So you're holding sort of a secret weapon, and what would you suggest you do with that?
Right now it would be like the best time to fly it. The problem with this and what we're having right now is we have a lot of heat, it's very dry. These travel water, so the nematodes are biological. You apply them onto your lawn, and then you want to keep it moist, so you can either wait till it rains or use a sprinkler system. So they cover a lot, maybe 3,000 square feet. They don't need to be refrigerated, which is really nice. And you just apply them and.
But then the damage isn't done, because then they turn into grubs.
They do, yeah.
And so the grubs then do what to your lawn?
They feed on the root system, so they cause similar damage as the chinch bugs. So that's why it's very important to actually go out and look at those damaged areas. If you see chinch bugs, then you've identified the problem. If you don't see any insect at all, then it's Japanese beetle or European chafer. In case you're going to be wanting to apply a different type of nematode.
Okay, the one called grub buster.
Yeah.
Sounds serious.
Yeah, very important to actually identify the pests that you're trying to treat.
So this is something that you can get on top of if you have this beautiful lawn that's suddenly been destroyed. You can kind of regain and add a healthy ecosystem.
Yeah.
Okay, good to know, because the next thing that will happen is skunks will be attracted to the grubs, and you'll see all kinds of huge spots where they'll dig and munch. Chinch bugs. I call them cinch bugs, but apparently nothing until this solution is a cinch about them. Patricia, we're going to be back and share some of these high performers from the garden. I don't know, is your thumb green? My thumb is not green. Leanne, with all the beetles in my brain, says thank you. Okay, coming up, I got an emergency landing caught on camera and a faithful companion.
That's right.
I once found a girl found the perfect Darren Dog. I'm Claire Wickerson,
and I'm Patricia Ball. We are
also number one news. We are source for live local breaking news.